What's wrong with corporatization? Or what's wrong with democracy? Is democracy going the wrong way? Is anybody threatening democracy? Who says or who assesses, who evaluates where democracy is going? I'm not going to talk about India, of course. It is not my job to talk about India. I'm an ambassador, but I would like, and I can talk about international democracy and the lessons about whether there is or there is not international democracy and how democracy in the international arena affects life and democracy in different countries, in Asia, in Africa, in Latin America, in Europe.
Only 34 channels, they belong to Doordarshan, which is a national broadcasters. And when I talk about newspapers, out of 40,000 newspapers which are well established in this country, only probably 40 to 50 newspapers are run by the government offices. So you can well imagine. So someone this morning asked me, sir, can you give me a letter of recommendation because I want to apply for a government job. I say, my dear friend, my letter won't work now because the whole media is in the hands of private people. It's only what you're going to be. If you have learned well, if you have done well, if you have trained yourself well into this institution, you have a wonderful scope in this market. But if you have not even attended a one seminar of this kind, who's going to help you, my dear friend? So, my dear friends, remember that. I'm very happy that all of you are here and you're going to go back home with so much of knowledge which you're going to gain from these kind of workshops, seminars.
Millennial. But if we talk about millennials, the generation Z, generation Y, they are all on digital media, and with the advent of smartphones. And a few years ago, we did not have as much. Not everybody had a smartphone, but I think now it's everybody is does have most people, I would say. Let's not call it every.